So even want to pray for miracles. Now, there must be this clarity in my mind first, that God is not about to bless me. When he gave Jesus, he gave me all the blessings I will ever need in life. He gave me my miracle. He gave me my healing. He gave me my deliverance. He gave me my next level of victory and promotion. When he gave Jesus, that settles it first. So when you're going to pray, I say, what prayer does, it changes you. It doesn't change God. It's the same way if you keep saying you're a sinner, rather than saying you are the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. This is the same reason people that struggle with sin, that are always confessing their sins, you know, confessing their sins. Oh God, I'm a sinner, by mentioning the sin. Oh God, I'm a sinner. Am I uncleanly? Oh God, I am unholy. Oh God, I'm unrighteous. People that keep saying, talking like that, never rise up. They always go back to the same addiction over and over and over. They think that when you say it long enough, you will break out of that addiction. It doesn't work. The Bible said faith calls those things that be not as though they were, they become. How, what is the cure? What you do at that point? You declare the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. I have dominion over sin. Greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. There is no stopping me. When I show up, the life of God has showed up. The ways are the work in me. There is nothing hindering me. I have dominion over sin. The devil is a defeated bastard. Glory to God. I reign in this life. I reign in the life to come. Glory to God. I'm a king. You talk. So when you begin to talk that way, something happens to you. Praise God forevermore. Now, what your words do, they begin to build inner strength on the inside of you. You are becoming conscious of your spiritual lineage, of the DNA of God in your spirit. You are becoming conscious of it. This is what dominates you. This is what dominates addiction. This is what breaks it. You maintain your confession. You keep declaring it. Some people have said, you know, they have said they've lived a sin conscious life for too long. Their normal routine of prayers is, Father, thank you for this morning, you know. Thank you, thank God. Then, second prayer point, you know the second one. And now let's begin to confess our sins. The one in your thought, the one you know, the one you don't know. You know, you keep mentioning it. And everybody goes silent. That prayer part, most times it was only silent. Like, they talk like that. The one I know, unknown and unknown. The one of my forefathers that came upon me. The one of the ancient lineage that came up. You know, many times. But beloved, Jesus died for. Glory to God. The man that is born again, the Bible says you have been born to the family of God. You have come into God's own family. You are in God's lineage. In this lineage, there is no sin. And someone give the Lord a good shout of praise. Ah!